and foremost, I thought we had a tremendous crowd. I thought they did a good job. Really standing after that. Very impressive. I think that was one of the things that got us over the hump. I think that speaks volumes about the University of Tennessee, the fans across the state. We have a team that's, you know, up and down, struggling, competing, finding ways to win games. Bad weather, ice on the ground, whatever the case may be, you got fans still show up. Very impressive, much appreciated. I think up until this point, we're 1-5 going into the half this season. Finding a way to win against a very talented team. A team with really good guards. When you have good guards, they can control the tempo of the game. Tough team to play. A team you hate to play, but you love to play as a competitor. But the guards do such a tremendous job controlling tempo. They can make free throws and make plays. We out rebounded by 15. Very impressed with Jordan and Kenny Hall. Even though they got blood, that's the Jordan Hill. I think he can be a special player. I mean, rebounds, physical. Couldn't take him off the floor. It was fun to see that, to see how he competed. But I thought up until this point, even back when we played Alabama at third place, I thought he was very aggressive, just didn't get the ball as much. Some fouls didn't go his way, but I thought he was aggressive. And it's good to see, have a game like this where he can go out and say, man, you know, it's good for him, happy for him. It's been a struggle, and I think more mental than anything, because I thought he's been in the game, but he's such a competitive player. He wants to be successful. You have all the accolades. From a statistical standpoint, you probably don't feel like you're playing the way you're capable of playing. It's good to see. I'm so happy for him. Armani, competing. Tough young guy, all over the place, except challenges. Our guard stepped up. Jordan made plays. Proved to be the scorer that he's capable of being. He did, made the plays we need to, make big shots. It was very aggressive, so great win for everybody involved.
Coach, to pull out a game finally down the stretch, what does that do to your team's confidence going forward?
Well, good question. I think the biggest thing, like I told our guys, I really applaud the fact that they come back after a tough loss with their hard hat on, continue to practice. And it's so tough when you continue to lose, the same way, two or three different things. And to find a way to win against a very talented team, I think they were up 6 or 7, 4 minutes left in the game, something like that. And to buckle down and get stops, really compete, and to win. And also, with Trey Golden, a guy that's, been up and down, to be in the game down the stretch and defend the way he defended with Trevor Miller, which is not an easy thing to do. I was happy to see that as well.
What did you tell your team at the timeout with 11 seconds to go? Because obviously, that was a good no-call, like in my opinion, from looking at it.
I said, you have to sit down and defend. That's what we do. We've been here before, guys. At some point, we got to pull one out. I thought Jordan did a good job of switching on, forcing them to drive that ball. Now you got to get a stop, keep your hands up high. I thought we did a good job. But we figured they'd come with that play because I think the previous time, now one or two times out, they ran it. Trevor Lacy had a 3-pointer. So just felt like switching that one and trust Jordan's defense. He did a great job.
Just from your vantage point, what you saw actually on that last play, how it developed, the job that Jordan did?
Oh, he did a great job. We figured they'd run that play. Everybody else was solid defensively. Late games, we're watching, they're going with Trevor. Even though Trevor Relliff is a tremendous guy with the ball, Trevor Lacy is a guy down the stretch, and they need a basket. We felt like that would be a play they'd run. They isolate him. I thought Josh would be in great shape with the ball screen coming off. We just felt like they switch this thing with Jordan Stokes. The way Jordan played, normally in a case like that, we'd probably go 5 guards and switch everything. But I thought Jordan had such a tremendous game. Let's keep him out there. And it's just fitting that he was the guy to get this stop.
Because when Jarnell is allowed to be physical and not getting called for ticky-tack fouls, is this the type of player that we can expect a lot more often?
Oh, I think so. It's hard to guard a guy like that. If he's allowed to play, but once again, I feel a foul's a foul. I don't care if it's a foul we call it, whoever's on it. But just because he's a big physical guy, the foul can't be different for him than it is for a guy that's 5'6". If it's a foul, it's a foul. So if he's allowed to be aggressive and do the things he needs to do, then he's a special talent.
Coach, this whole episode of him, then you've got to reevaluate how you had to deal with officials. Today it looked like you got this beast in once there was no call. You got fired up. Next time down, there was a touch foul.
The thing I always say, I've never had a problem with officials. I don't think any official going to a game and saying, I want to make this call on his team. These guys are men, they have families. This is part of their job. Nobody's perfect. I make mistakes. And But my thing is, just be fair, whether we're home on the road, let's be fair with this thing. And I just, when I watch out certain things with him, because he gets hit, but he has such a strong frame, he's not moving like most guys, then it's probably not considered a foul. I just say, if it's a foul, it's a foul. Whether it's our guys or anybody, just call it. But I talk to those guys, and I don't be disrespectful. I'm not one of those guys to go out there, okay, this game, let me get a ticket. If it happens, it happens. I mean, my job is to protect my players, and I just felt like, and I've never in my career called a commissioner until, you know, this point one time. I just said, man, let's balance this thing out with him, not necessarily all other guys, whatever happens. But in that case, I just wasn't looking right.
Jordan went out, I think, the first night you missed the game, didn't score 2 points. You scored that last basket right before halftime, the second half. Did he kind of maybe adjust how they were playing him, or what kind of changed with him?
No, I think what happens is he positioned himself to be a scorer. And that's what he is now. This is a part of now. Teams defend you certain ways, they physical, which they make it hard for you to get catches. That's part of it. Then you make the adjustment. Any scorer makes the necessary adjustments to be successful. Find the scenes. He did a good job in the second half of Ben. But the one thing about him, he's going to shoot the ball. That's going to happen. And I thought he was aggressive. He's in attack mode. Shot his floor. Made a 3-point, if I'm not mistaken. And he has to do that. Scores miss shots. And scores have tough halves. Last game we just played, that score had a bad first half, but we did in the second half. I just think you got to be built and be ready to score the ball.
Yeah, the bench really kind of stormed onto the floor after that game. I guess what was the atmosphere like in the postgame? Was just a sense of relief? Or?
I think so. You know, when you put the work in, just like, once again, a 15-pound weight off your shoulder, because we put the work in and just, you know, turn over here, miss free throw. And this time we missed a free throw late, which, in my opinion, one of the best free throw shooters in the league. But we got to stop needing to win the game. But the guys were excited. They were jumping around. And they should be, because, like I said, they put the work in. This is a win that was earned. It's a very talented team.
Coach, I know that Trey is starting, but at the end of big games, when it's close, he's always on the floor. Is that just the confidence that you have in him to finish games?
I mean, to want a guy, like I said, his percentage doesn't say it now, but a 90% free throw shooter, you got to have him on the floor. You better ball him, your best ball him on the team. So you want the ball in his hand. Like I said, in order for us to be the best team we can be, we need Trey Gold and Jordan Stokes to be at a high level every night.
Coach, you wore the gym shoes today for a very worthy cause. It's very personal to you as well. Can you tell us a little bit about what that means to you?
Truthfully, I try to forget it as much as I can. It's just one word is extremely hard for me to say, so I never really say it. But it's part of life. You deal with it for a great cause. But, you know, just not for me today. I do it all year round. My wife and I do so many different things. And just. It's a part of my life. You deal with it, keep moving forward.
You thought of the rebound, Matt. When you go against his own team, is that kind of an emphasis to, you know, crash the offensive glass? And you like you've got to step that up and say that.
Well, the thing about it, when you have Armani and Josh on the floor, I thought Jordan and Kenny Hall controlled the glass. Even though Kenny had 12 offense, I thought those guys were very aggressive. But Josh and Armani are really good offensive rebounding guards. So now you have all those guys tipping the balls, it's tough. Now you're playing against the zone. Now you can identify where you're cutting to get that basketball. But the thing about with these guys, if you don't get it, they're down your back. They're really good in transition. But I thought we were able to capitalize on a lot of it.
Coming off the quick turnaround, 21 turnovers at Ole Miss. Did you address something? Was something changed in terms of just controlling the ball, or, you know, not being so loose with it?
Not really. We spent, you know, two things we spent a lot of time on: press offense. Zone offense. We've been better in those areas. Just like when I left Ole, when we left the Ole Miss game, I was very surprised. I saw 21 turnovers because I thought we did a great job against the press. We didn't have any turnovers, but we had travel calls, we had, you know, charge calls, and I was surprised by the 21 turnovers. Same way tonight, I thought we did a good job of having that press. So wasn't necessarily surprised. I thought for the most part we've done a good job. We spent so much time in those two areas.
Thank you, Mark.
I expect them to continue doing what they're doing. Capitalize on, you know, a few minor things here and there, the mental prep. But they've been working, I said all along, outside of, you know, a game and a half all season, those guys have been putting the work in. You're starting to see results of it. But you lose tough games, you've been in ball games, it's unfortunate. Tonight it bounced all the way.
It's a tough stretch for you guys. Thursday, Saturday, Tuesday, and different weeks.
Probably not for the guys, because we don't get a chance to practice. They might like it, you know, just And we walked through yesterday for about 40 minutes, and we'll walk through tomorrow. Just all prep work, everything mental, shoot free throws, and we get out of there.
Kazo, you're the defensive guy. Getting a stop at the end versus getting the last second buzzer beat, I know you probably prefer to stop.
It was me if it stopped. But I think you get the fans what you want. You can make a basket, then that's great too. I mean, because at the end of the day, this is entertainment, you know. These are amateur athletes, and they put a lot of work and time into what they do. But it's, at the end of the day, it's entertainment.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.